Good morning. Now we will find the spin angular momentum of Dirac particle. Spin cannot be determined independently. It can be determined by coupling with the orbital motion. The advantage of Dirac Hamiltonian is that spin is evolving as a natural consequence of the Dirac Hamiltonian. We know the Dirac Hamiltonian as H equal to C alpha dot P plus beta m c square, or we can write c alpha x p x plus alpha y p y plus alpha z p z plus beta m c square. Now we find the conservation from, we will calculate the spin angular momentum from conservation of angular momentum, and we are expecting that the angular momentum, the orbital angular momentum of system is conserved, and we will write the equation of motion for orbital angular momentum. We know from Heisenberg picture the equation of motion is I h bar d omega h by dt, where omega h is an operator. I h bar d omega h by dt is equal to commutator of omega h with the Hamiltonian plus I h bar dou omega h by dou t. If omega h is not having any explicit dependence on time, then dou omega h by dou t will be equal to 0. So it will be I h bar d omega h by dt equal to omega h h. So if omega h is a constant of motion, then d omega s by dt is equal to 0. If d omega s by dt is equal to 0, then naturally commutator omega h, that must be equal to 0 when omega h is a constant of motion. So using that equation, we will do the conservation of orbital angular momentum. And we are taking orbital angular momentum. We know that L equal to R cross P. So the X component of orbital angular momentum, Lx, we can write it as Y Pz minus Cz Py. So if Lx is a constant of motion, then if I h bar d Lx by dt, that is equal to Lx h. If Lx is a constant of motion, then this term should be equal to 0. So we will calculate the commutator of Lx with the Hamiltonian. The Dirac Hamiltonian is C alpha x, C alpha dot p plus beta m c square. Instead of Lx, we can substitute it as y p z minus z p y. So it will be equal to y p z minus z p y, comma, h is c alpha x p x plus alpha y p y plus alpha z p z plus beta m c square. So this we can write it as commutator y p z with c alpha x p x plus, we can expand this into different terms, y p z with the alpha x p x. So here y, commutator of y with the p x, that will be 0. Y p x, commutator y p x will be 0. What is y p y? Y p y will be I h bar. X p x, it is I h bar. X p y will be 0. X p z will be 0. X p x will be I h bar. So here y px, that will be 0. Then another commutator we will be having pz px. Commutator px pz is 0. Py pz is 0. Px py, py pz, pz px, all these are 0. So all the term, all the commutators, when you expand this term, all the commutators of y pz with c alpha x px, all these terms will be 0. Now take another, this one. In this case, we will be having one non-zero commutator. So we will be having one y, py. So first term, commutator of this one with this one I am not taking because all the terms are zero. Now I am taking the commutator y p z with c alpha y p y. Here we can have non-zero commutator. Then another one y p z with c alpha z p z. Y p z that commutator will be zero. P z commutator will be zero. So I am not taking this one. I am not taking this one. I have taken this also. I am not taking. Now take the commutator of y p y. Y p y with this one. Y z is not y. Z p y. Z p y with this one. All these commutators will be zero. Now z p y with alpha y p y. This also will be zero. Now z p y with alpha z p z. So one z and p z are there. So that commutator is not equal to zero. So I am writing minus z p y commutator of z p y with c alpha z p z. Now c alpha z p z. Now y p z with beta m c square. Beta commutes with y and p z, so that will be zero. This commutator with this one will be zero, and this one commutator of this one with this one, that also will be zero. So we will be having only two commutators. Now that is having non-zero value. That commutators are given here. So this term we can simplify it as this term y p y commutator y p y c alpha y. C alpha y taken to this side and p z is taken to right, so it will be y p y into p z. So when you expand this, you will be having four commutators: commutator alpha y, then y p y, p z alpha y, p z p y. All the commutators except this one will be zero. Minus. Now the commutator of z p z, that means p y is taken to right. C alpha z is taken to left, so it is C alpha z commutator z p z into p y. Now what is this one? C alpha y into y p y. Y p y is C alpha y I h bar p z minus C alpha z p z is I h bar. So I h bar p y. So we will be having I h bar c alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. That means the commutator of Lx with the Dirac Hamiltonian is not equal to zero. When you take the commutator of Ly with the Dirac Hamiltonian, then you will be having another component. You can take the permutations x, y, z, then you will be having another non-zero value. When you take the commutator of Lz with the Hamiltonian, you will be having another term. That means ih bar dl by dt equal to commutator Lh, which is not equal to zero. So the angular momentum, orbital angular momentum, is not equal to a constant. If it is equal to a constant, then its commutator with the Hamiltonian should be equal to zero. So we have to add some additional term to angular momentum, to orbital angular momentum, such that the total angular momentum should be constant. And now we will prove that additional term to be added with this orbital angular momentum, that additional term is spin angular momentum, and we will now calculate that spin angular momentum. This equation I require further, so I am writing here ih bar dlx by dt is equal to lx h is equal to ih bar c alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. I am taking this as equation number 1. So we have already calculated the magnetic moment, and in magnetic moment a new term appeared, that is sigma prime. That sigma prime is given by sigma 0 0 sigma. If it is sigma x prime, then it will be sigma x 0 0 sigma x, sigma y prime sigma y 0 0 sigma y, and sigma z prime is sigma z 0 0 sigma z. Then alpha x, we know alpha x 0 sigma x, sigma x 0 is alpha x, alpha y is 0 sigma y 0, and alpha z is 0 sigma z 0, alpha x, alpha y, alpha z, sigma x prime, sigma y prime, sigma z prime, all these are 4 by 4 matrices. So the sigma x prime, sigma y prime, sigma z prime are the components of sigma prime. Alpha x, alpha y, alpha z are the components of alpha, and the sigma x, sigma y, sigma z are poly spin matrices, and they are 2 by 2 matrices. We know their property. Sigma x, sigma y, what is sigma x, sigma y? I sigma z. Sigma y, sigma z is I sigma x. Like that, we have already obtained that relation. Now I take the sigma prime and find the commutator of sigma prime with the x. First I take the x component of sigma prime, so it is sigma x prime with x. So equation of motion will be I h bar d sigma x prime by dt equal to sigma x prime h. What is Hamiltonian? Dirac Hamiltonian, sigma x prime. Dirac Hamiltonian is C alpha x p x plus alpha y p y plus alpha z p z plus beta m c square. Take the commutator of sigma x prime with all this. So beta commutes with the sigma x prime, so that commutator will be 0. Sigma x prime with the beta will be 0. Don't take this commutator. Now take the commutator of this one. Px commutes with sigma x prime. So commutator sigma x prime px will be 0. Here we will be having one commutator sigma x prime alpha x. So here the term will be C commutator sigma x prime alpha x into px. Now the second term, this one with this one, it will be plus C commutator sigma x prime alpha y into py. Sigma x prime py, that commutator will be 0. Now the commutator of this one with this one, sigma x prime px commutator will be 0. So we will be having plus C into sigma x prime alpha z into pz. Now we find the commutator of sigma x prime alpha x, sigma x prime into alpha x. First I find the product of sigma x prime and alpha x. What is sigma x prime? Sigma x 0 0 sigma x. And what is alpha x? 0 sigma x 0. So when you take the product, this will be 0 0, then this one with this one, sigma x square, then product of this one with this one, sigma x square, this one into this one, 0. Sigma x square is 1. So it is 0, 1, 1, 0. Now find the value alpha x sigma x prime. It will be 0 sigma x 0 into sigma x 0, 0 sigma x. What is this one? Product of this one with this one, 0. This one with this one, sigma x square. This one with this one, sigma x square, 0. So this is 0, 1, 1, 0. That means sigma x prime alpha x is same as alpha x sigma x prime. So sigma x prime alpha x minus alpha x sigma x prime, that will be equal to 0. So the commutator sigma x prime alpha x is 0. So the first term is sigma x prime alpha x is 0. Now find the value of sigma x prime alpha y. Sigma x prime alpha y. So this is sigma x prime alpha y. So this will be sigma y. Alpha y is 0, sigma y 0. So this product will be sigma x, sigma y. Here also sigma x, sigma y. What is sigma x, sigma y? Sigma x, sigma y is I sigma is. So this will be I sigma is. Here also we will be having I sigma is. Now find the value alpha x, sigma x prime 0, sigma x 0. No, it is alpha y, sigma x prime. Alpha y, sigma x prime. So 0, sigma y 0. Sigma x 0, 0 sigma x. Its product will be sigma y sigma x. Here it will be sigma y sigma x is I sigma z. So sigma y sigma x will be minus I sigma z. So this will be minus I sigma z. Here also minus I sigma z 0. Taking I common, then it will be I into 0 sigma z 0. What is 0 sigma z 0? It is alpha z. So we can write this as I alpha z. What about this one? Take minus I common, then it will be 0 sigma z 0. So this one will be minus I alpha z. So take the difference, sigma x prime alpha y minus alpha y sigma x prime. That will be equal to I sigma I alpha z minus I alpha z. So it will be 2I alpha z. That means commutator sigma x prime alpha y. That will be equal to 2I alpha z. So this commutator, this is equal to 0. This commutator sigma x prime alpha y. Sigma x prime alpha y. We can write this commutator as 2i alpha z. 2i alpha z. In a similar way, you can calculate sigma x prime alpha z. Sigma x prime alpha z. This will be minus 2i x z. So it will be alpha y. This is not in order. Z x. X y z. X. So it is x z. So it will be minus. You can, when you calculate sigma x prime alpha z, it will be minus 2i alpha y. So this will be minus 2i alpha y. So we are having the equation as this commutator as 2i c alpha z p y minus 2i c alpha y p z. Taking minus 2ic common, minus 2ic into alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. Alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. Here also alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. Here the coefficient, here it is I h bar c, and here it is I h bar c. You can calculate I h bar from both the sides. So you will be having cancel I h bar from both sides. Then you will be having dlx by dt is equal to c into alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. This I am taking it as equation number 2. And this equation I h bar, this I you can cancel from both the sides, I. So it will be h bar d sigma x prime by dt is equal to, right hand side you are having minus 2c alpha y p z minus alpha z p y. When you add these two terms, you should get 0 on right hand side. For getting 0 on right hand side, I can take this 2 to left hand side. When I take 2 to left hand side, then it will be h bar by 2. So when you add these two equations, equations 2 and 3, left hand side you can write it as d by dt of, here it is lx plus, here it is half h bar sigma x prime. On the right hand side you will be getting 0. That means d by dt of lx is not equal to 0, but you can get 0 when we add some quantity to lx. So in general, this is the x component. In a similar way, you can write the y component, d by dt of ly plus I half h bar sigma y prime equal to 0. Z component, d by dt of lz plus half h bar sigma z prime equal to 0. Combining all these three terms, you can write d by dt of l plus half h bar sigma prime, that is equal to 0. That means the orbital angular momentum L alone is not constant of motion, but when you add certain quantity to orbital angular momentum, then that quantity, its rate of change will be 0. The total angular momentum is a constant of motion, so you can write the total angular momentum, this is L, and you are adding some other quantity. Yes, this is total angular momentum, this is equal to a constant of motion. So this term we can take that as the spin angular momentum half h bar sigma prime. So the spin angular momentum, the expression for spin angular momentum is half h bar sigma prime, and we know that the sigma prime is a 4 by 4 matrix, and so the wave function psi also should have 4 components. In plane wave solution we have taken psi, the four components psi 1, psi 2, psi 3, psi 4, and we have written u 1 e raised to minus I mc square by h bar, I minus mc square t by h bar, like that. We have written psi 1, then psi 2, psi 3, psi 4. So the wave function psi should be a column vector with the four components, and we have found the solution for that. And the first two components for positive energy eigenvalue, we obtain the first two components as strong components and the second two components as weak components. So when you multiply this with the 4 by 4 matrix, and I am grouping these two, psi 1, psi 2, I am grouping it as psi 1, and this psi 3, psi 4, I am grouping it as psi 2, and this 4 by 4 matrix I am writing sigma prime, I am writing it as sigma 0, 0, sigma. So when you multiply this with this one, you are multiplying the four component psi 1, it represents the first two components, and psi 2 the third and fourth components, and this is a 4 by 4 matrix, and this is also a column matrix with the four components, and I am duping them into 2 by 2 matrix. So this two psi 1 is a column vector with the two components, psi 2 is a column vector with the two components, this sigma is a 2 by 2 matrix, this 0 is 2 by 2, this sigma is 2 by 2, 0 is 2 by 2 matrix, and the 4 by 4 matrix, the 4 component psi operating on 4 by 4 matrix is equivalent to, when I multiply this, the first row I will be having sigma into psi 1, the psi 1 is 2 component vector and sigma is a 2 by 2 matrix. So the four components operating on 4 by 4 matrix, that can be taken as equivalent to the two components operating on the operator sigma. The two components for positive energy eigenvalue, we have already seen that the first two components are strong components and the last two components are weak components. So sigma prime, the wave function, the four component wave function operating on the operator psi, sigma prime, the 4 by 4 matrix, is equivalent to the operation of two strong components on the operator sigma. So when you take the two strong components, the same spin can be written as half h bar instead of sigma prime. sigma 0 0 sigma, I can write it as sigma when you consider the two strong components for positive energy eigen value. So we have obtained the expression for spin angular momentum as s is equal to half h bar sigma. This we have already obtained this equation for magnetic moment of electron, where we have represented the magnetic moment in terms of s, and s is equal to half h bar sigma. So this spin is evolving as a natural consequence of Dirac Hamiltonian. Okay, thank you.